Don Rumsfeld has been a superb
leader. There's fucking rappers sitting outside. Come on in, Rapp. Hey, Rapp. Holy shit. Come on in, Rapp. Buddy.
Hey, what do you say, my man?
Bro?
Good to see you, pal.
Been forever.
How you doing?
I guess all right. I've just been treated like a terrorist, but it was good.
What happened? Trying
tight
to
tight security out there, brother. Good to see, though. Good to see.
Dave, come and get me if somebody shows up at the door. How long did it take you to get in?
Just 20, 25 minutes. No big deal. They just wanted to make sure you were safe.
You don't have any liquids on you or anything that needed to be checked at the gate.
The funny thing, all you got to do is wait another 15 minutes and then you can walk right in. How long did it take you today, Sheepy?
Oh, I got right in. He learned his lesson.
Good one, Sheep.
Rapper, what are you doing, man?
Just took a ride up to see you, pal.
Good
nothing else
you,
going on.
You're in North Jersey still?
Yep, still in North Jersey.
Nice.
Not much of a drive.
Still a slumlord?
Still a slumlord.
Good news.
Business is booming.
You just missed my brother was just here.
Yesterday, I think I heard you talking
about
it.
Was it yesterday?
It.
I cannot
Monday.
Came up this fucking week. I guess he left yesterday.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, came in Monday, left yesterday on a fly. He was just back in the old hood, and everybody's still there. He came up with something of everybody was still together and has never moved.
Yeah, it's pretty much that way. I get over that way from time to time. It's like, you know, the names have changed, but the faces are still the same.
Well, it's good to see you, bro.
You too.
Here's Mark. Mark, you're on Ron and Rapp show. How are you, pal?
Fez.
Well, I mean my dream show, Ron and Rapp. Do we got you, Mark? Do you got the board back up the way it's supposed to be?
Yes.
So we don't have you, Mark. Well, let me try this one. Ed, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, how you doing? I got two things. First, Fezzy should wear defibrillator pads around on his chest all the time and carry the unit around. So this way, if he ever goes down, you just run up and press the button.
And Fezzy, have you ever bought one of those portable defibrillators?
I have not done that.
Yeah. Fezzy, Rapp, since the last time we saw you, Fez had a heart attack. And Friday is his one-year anniversary.
Oh, I'm well aware of that, Ronnie. I listen to the show just about every day, and I'm getting tired of him whining, to be honest with you. I had some major heart problems right around the same time.
What happened with you, bro?
I had an enlarged heart.
Oh, yeah.
Very serious problem, but, you know, I got over it and I moved on.
You had heart problems in fucking high school. His fucking nose used to explode.
Well... Yeah, I got this one from a confrontation with my neighbor. My blood pressure was pretty well smoking.
You're fighting the neighbor?
Yeah, it came down to that, and I was afraid I was going to kill him and go back to prison, so...
Let me guess. Did you do it the Rapicelli way, where you hit him with a big pick?
Ronnie, you would have been proud of me, brother. I'm going to tell you, I went, and I'm ashamed to say it, I went the law and order route.
Really?
Had them call the police, had them come, had them take care of it. It was the worst move of my life.
The police didn't come and pick you up?
No, they took everything, and it was all his fault.
Right.
So somebody tells him to go and file charges against me at the same time. So, you know, we get in front of the judge, and then, like, they pretty much didn't want to be bothered with it.
Yeah, it's a problem in front of the judge.
And I'm trying to tell the DA, like, we've had a little bit of a history in my family with this.
Yeah.
You know, where somebody could end up really getting hurt. They didn't want to hear it.
Yeah. His brother was a neighbor of another friend of ours. They had an what was the argument about?
Well, Danny was trying to screw his wife.
Well, whatever. The thing is this, so his brother hits him in the ass with this giant fucking pick. How bad did it hurt him?
He was in intensive care for 2 weeks and then a nursing home for 30 days.
But it was like a big thing, like you're going to dig
pickaxe,
a fucking hole in.
Yeah.
Big fucking pickaxe.
Big one.
Fucking hit him in the back with it.
In the ass.
Right in the ass?
One more inch, it would have cut his jugular. He would have bled out there on the driveway.
Yeah, you can lose a lot of blood at your ass.
Yeah. Oh, he did.
You would know that more than anyone. You're the fucking finally place where you can put on I'm the fucking pro thing. No doubt about it. But that all got straightened out. Everybody's friends again.
Well, Danny's dead.
Well,
so
what are you going
to
do?
It's hard not to be friends now.
Yeah, sure. Well, you know, everybody goes to the same heaven. That's my fucking feeling about it.
Pick heaven.
Yeah. And we'll all fucking meet up there and we'll fucking really work it out. Just fucking swinging it. This way, when we fight, we can have wings.
There you go.
You're wearing thicker glasses than the last time I saw you.
Yes, I am, brother. We ain't getting any younger.
You losing some sight?
Yeah, yeah, I'm falling apart, man.
Oh, good.
Falling apart.
Well, you know, I mean, you were literally falling apart as a kid. So
I was, right.
Nothing, you know,
I haven't taken the best care of myself. I keep trying
no
to
one
tell
did.
The doctor.
I never thought. I figured 21 tops is how long I needed my body. So when I hit the 30 thing, I went, whoa, when do I retire? After that, it's all fucking, you know, who knows. But literally, and I was talking with my brother about this. We would be like 18, 19, and people would be walking with canes. You had fucking dissolved your body. And my uncle died of, you know, cirrhosis of the liver and all, as a really old man, at like age 33, 34, 35. I went back to put it together. But at the time, we're like, hey, he had a fucking wild life. Partied his ass off. We were thinking he got the full run out of it at 34, 35, because he really was elderly by the time he died.
Well, we probably buried, what, 20, 25 friends, easy.
Easily.
Easily. Yeah. Easily. And all from not taking care of himself.
Well, and bullets were fucking, one of the other things, bullets were a problem. And the inability to wake up after a night of party.
That'll do it. That almost happened to me. Remember up the mountains?
Yeah.
You and Wardy were by my side taking me to see that Oriental doctor. I'll never forget it. And no party no more. No party no more.
It's so fucking bad because, you know, we went up to this place. We rented out, you know, we had these fucking broads with us. We had every known substance known to man. Everybody's having a fucking great time in and out of these fucking bedrooms with these chicks. Everything's great. All of a sudden, there's fucking Rapp. He's just literally bleeding out.
On the toilet, remember?
Yeah.
He said it was like Elvis.
Yeah, just fucking, the blood is gushing from his nose, everywhere else. So we take him over. We're like, well, he's a fucking dead man. We take him to the fucking hospital. No sooner do they go, they fucking get his heart re-going. And again, what are we, 20, 19 years old?
19 top,
not old enough to even fucking drink. And we're already 6, 7 years into this fucking run. 6, 7 years into a bad fucking run of, you know, going, I haven't slept during high school. You know, I mean, really fucking wired. As soon as we know we got his heart fucking stabilized again, we're going, let's get out of here without paying. Let's fucking, the man who just saved your life, let's beat him. And then, literally, while they're working on Rapp, trying to, you know, calm his fucking rabbit heart down, everybody else is looking for pills. Just fucking
going through my dope.
Yeah. Well, yours, the hospitals, everything. And, you know, the doctor's like, what have you guys been doing? And, you know, you try, at that point, you got to fucking turn on. So you're like, cocaine, yeah. Methamphetamine, yeah. Angel dust. The guy's like, is there a fucking box I can't hit here?
Just all of the above.
Yeah. And it's been, like you said, a fucking long run. But, you know, then later you suffer. What are you going to do?
What are you going to do?
Right. You want to sit at the cold table in high school? You're not going to be sitting around. You're not going to go to the old folks' home. You get to go one way or the other.
There you go.
Well, this has got to piss you off, as a rapper. I know that you're fucking right wing as hell.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That could impact my my income here.
Yeah. Rapp has how many?
22 ghetto homes.
22 ghetto homes he owns right now. Now, if we were playing Monopoly, Rapp would have all his houses on those first purple fucking streets.
Politics?
Yeah, he has those. So he owns these homes that you're pretty afraid to go collect the rent on. You have to fucking say to yourself, well, I'm either going to get the rent or I'm going to get killed on the way there today. Have you ever had any problems with that rent?
Oh, yeah. I've been mugged once.
Yeah.
Two big guys. And that was about it.
But generally, do they send your... does the government send you checks? Or how
government sends me a sum, and then some I go and I pick up on my own.
Yeah.
They're the dangerous ones.
Now, here's the thing. Some of these people that are impoverished, Rapp will throw them out if they're late. You know what I mean? Like, families, doesn't matter to him.
How late do they have to be before they're gone, Rapper?
1 week.
One week and they're out.
That money.
Yeah.
They got no chance of catching up. Where are they going to pull the money from?
So why not put them out in the street where they belong?
Amen. Amen.
No, I was trying to be sarcastic.
No.
I wasn't fucking, you know, setting you up for an easy slam. Fez, doesn't matter. If snowstorm, They're nursing babies.
Elderly?
We have a potential baby nursing going to be evicted any day now. She keeps saying she'd be sending the rent, but I don't be getting it, so she's going to be parting company with
it. I'm sure not all of them talk that way. I'm sure not all of them.
90%. 90%. It's a different culture.
You know, the other thing is, Rapp is a guy I've known for a long, long time, but Rapp is an inventor. He invented something in that business, and that is carpeting. Every home has to come with carpeting, right?
Yes.
Rapp came up with a brand new invention. I'll go ahead and tell people what that is.
Painted in carpeting.
Painted in carpeting. So what he does is paint the floors, and then do you call it carpeting or?
Well, I've turned to calling it an alternative flooring source to get with the times. You know,
right.
Everybody else is doing that, so I had to give it a positive spin.
I heard the president call for that today. Alternative flooring sources.
Now you, but you're all settled down. You have family now.
Nice family. A 4 and a 6 year old.
They know anything about daddy's past?
Oh, well, not about the past. They know daddy's a slumlord.
Right.
They call them the brown people when daddy takes them over to pick rent up.
Hey, that's a nicer name than your dad gave you to call him. I know that for a fact.
There is progress.
It certainly is.
So they know that this is going to be all theirs one day.
Yeah, they do know that.
The fact that any of those houses still stand up is amazing to me.
I call them the Menendez sisters. I say once the empire gets big enough, one of them's going to put one in me, which I don't doubt.
But that's good. The fucking long shot thing, Fezzy, is that he goes to his wild years, and now he's got a nice wife, he's got kids. You can turn things around.
Yeah,
that's the point here.
You got a thriving business?
Thriving, thriving business. They're multiplying like rabbits, Fez.
Well, as long as... Wow, this is terrible. But as long as there's poor people, Rapp will be there to separate them from their money.
That's good when you find your calling like that.
Yeah,
and you know what you want to do with your life. You know what you're supposed to do.
The funny thing is he's basically taken PCP and traded it for fucking slum homes. And he has almost the same customer base.
And Ronnie, you forget about my star tenant, the now famous Don Vito Margera.
Oh, yeah, Don Vito was.
Remember the Florida days.
And then you and him had a big falling out, right?
Well, we did. You see, he was messing up the whole mojo of the building.
Right.
You know, he was the one guy with the cable. After that, he was supposed to let everybody else tap in.
Right.
He wouldn't do it, you know?
Now, why wouldn't he share cable?
He's just ignorant, man.
Right.
You gotta, look, when in Rome, do as the Romans do.
Right.
Plus, the thing of it was, they thought the building was turning white. I must have lost 5-6 good tenants.
So it's really bad when welfare people don't feel good, like that Don Vito has brought down the building a little bit.
Those mean signs go back to Europe.
Didn't you and him get caught up in some insurance thing, too, where there was a problem?
There was the insurance thing.
What happened there?
Well, I was in an accident in his van.
Right.
And he drags me to this lawyer. You know, talks me into suing and everything.
Right.
Well, here it ended up being determined that it was his fault. So I end up suing. Well, actually, it wasn't even his insurance. It was his brother Phil's insurance.
Right.
And he feels like he should get, like, a percentage of the take. And I'm like, fuck you, man. Take my band back, you know?
All right, how much money did you get?
I got $25,000.
And how much did he want?
He wanted, like, 20%.
Really?
I thought, fuck you. You ain't getting it.
But now you'd be part of his posse, and you'd be going from skate park to skate park, grabbing itty-bitty titty and just enjoying yourself.
Yeah. Well,
have you talked to him since for a while? Or?
Have not talked to him, and I guess, you know, he's monitoring his phone calls now. Somebody told me Bill Churchman, an old buddy of ours, trying to get a hold of him. Vincey would not take his phone call.
Well, what are you going to do? I got emails from Church, too. I didn't fucking answer.
Poor Church.
No, Church is like 6'6".
Oh, okay.
And he is, much like Don Vito, uncontrollable.
Oh.
Now, if I was to describe most of the people we grew up with, the word uncontrollable would be used quite a bit.
Well, you know, I'm a little pissed off at him, too. He's working with my cousin, right? Yeah, my cousin was young when I was, you know, in my shit. And he's telling my cousin all these stories, right? You remember when he meat cleavered the guy in the chest?
Right.
He fucking tells him I did it.
Oh, no.
And no. I said, I'll take credit for the shit I did. I did not meat cleaver nobody.
That is true. I don't, you know, if that ever comes up that way.
Thank you.
But, yeah, it's very hard sometimes to see people from the past. It doesn't mean you don't love them.
Right.
You love them. You care about them. But, you know, life goes on. You're not always on that same, in that same exact place. Crazyville. You're not always fucking the same. But here's what I love, Rapp. These fucking guys, they cry around me all the time. They fucking, oh, Ron's being mean. They have no fucking idea the restraint.
Ronnie, you know what? I listen to the show almost every day. I'm like semi-retired now, you know? And you don't know, man.
Semi-retired, you're taking money from poor people.
It's fucking hard opening up them envelopes. But, man, there's days I just want to come up here and just start fucking leveling people, man. I feel for you. I really do.
They don't know that I coddle them, and they don't know how little of an asshole I am to these fuckers. But what are you going to do? That's here or there. Rapp's uncle used to cut my hair, his Uncle Dino, when I was a kid, right? And he would always be your barber, plus have some merchandise. If anybody looks at one.
Nice.
So, he'd be cutting your hair a little bit, and he'd be going like this. Your mom likes string beans at all? I got cases of string beans. You're a grown boy. You like succotash? Let me know if you ever need any succotash. It's all here in the back. I don't know where he got it from, but you can leave there with a nice regular boy's haircut and a couple of cases of canned goods.
He actually ended up under investigation by the FBI. Remember them guys, the guy that killed his son? There's two kids for diming out on them that were robbing the trains.
Yeah.
That's where most of that shit was coming from.
Yeah.
One day he's out there mowing his lawn. Next thing you know, FBI pulls up off the tractor, buddy.
No. Yeah. When you got to kill your own kids to cover your fucking tracks. You know what I'm saying?
You're in a little deep then.
Yes. When the only way out is, hey, these two children that I've raised since babies, if I cut their throats, nobody can get to me now. Those fucking trains used to be like 7-Elevens. The fucking amount.
Fruit Growers Express, man. 50 cents a case Schlafier.
You would try to, you'd try to fucking go down to open the fucking train. You'd have to stand online. People would just be standing there with fucking crowbars trying to open up these things. Yeah, you're better off throwing out whatever, because there would be suddenly an abundance of one product, whatever it was. You could end up getting it for a quarter. Why be the guy who risks your fucking self to go down there? All right, 866-RON-0-FEZ, 866-RON-0-FEZ. The rapper surprises us today. And just to let us know that, you know, he's bitching about Master Poe. How good is the fucking security if Rapp can get through here at all? If he could ever make it through.
There's no background check.
Thank God. I wouldn't have got in there.
We're going to hang out a little bit. We'll take a break. We're right back. RON and Fez Show.
The RON and Fez Show.
XM 202.
RON and Fez Show, 866-RON-0-FEZ, 866-RON-0-FEZ. We got a consultant here today. My old buddy Rapp is here. He's going to be working with the staff. I'm going to have him work a couple days with Dave and Earl, and then maybe spend an afternoon with Fez.
Oh, nice. Life coach.
Yes.
You need it. You need training. You need conditioning. God, I get so aggravated days. I'm listening, man. I'm like, I'm going to drive up there and start kicking some fucking ass. But now I see you got that security out there. I don't know.
Master Poe, he's always ready. Now, he's already gone. See, he leaves halfway through our show. So if you,
I feel like you're really safe, pal.
Well, who's going to come hurt us anyway? I don't fucking know, you know. I don't know if there's anybody that can really feel like in danger here. But it is good to see you, Rapper.
Good to see you, pal.
You turn things around. You know, during the commercial break, we're coming up with old names that we won't mention on the air. And one after another, Rapper's like, oh, he's doing horrible. Oh, my God, no. It's terrible. He's still living in his dad's house. Oh, Jesus Christ, no. Oh, you don't remember? He's already dead. On and on. What are you going to do?
Nothing you can do, pal.
One after another.
Lucky we escaped.
You know why here the thing is now? You're going to spend a couple days with Eastside Dave, wipe the tears out of his eyes, wipe the tears out of Fezzy's eyes, and off we go.
Got to toughen these guys up, Ronnie.
You know why I know Rapp my whole life? Never saw him cry even once.
Really?
These guys are sobbing on a daily basis around here. Actually, tears were just a chance to fucking for the other kids to punch you. That was a chance for everyone to put the boots to you. Tears or that kid that used to live next year that had the braces on his legs? Remember that little kid when you were a little kid? We were like,
yeah, Jamison.
Yeah, I don't want to give out names.
Oh, okay, I'm
but,
sorry.
But for some reason, he went to school with us. He had fucking braces on his legs, and it only brought up the fucking the pain on the kids. They treated him like he was Piggy on a fucking island. You know what I mean? It's just the excuse to have a beatdown. Kids, I want you to be careful. This young man is having some physical problems.
Where do I get him after school?
Come here, brace leg. Any fucking thing at all.
That just means he can't get away.
Well, most people don't realize, we grew up with the Pagans. One of our towns right by us was their national headquarters when we were kids.
But you know what? I think it kept the town very safe. A lot of people don't say that about motorcycle gangs, but I happen to believe that there was a positive nature to that. That's where my elementary school was.
Yeah.
So we were able to feel, even though the police force wasn't on top of things, the motorcycle club had looked around to make sure that nobody bothered things in the neighborhood.
I guess it's nice to have a backup plan.
I thought it was very good. I saw them beat the living daylights out of this guy one day. The cops came and took the guy that they beat up away. And it made perfect sense to me. Like, what are they going to do? Oh, no, you guys in the car.
Yeah. All right, 866-RON-0-FEZ, 866-RON-0-FEZ.
We got breaking news from the election last night.
Yeah.
Montana has gone to the Democrats.
Montana goes to the Democrats. So really, that only will keep Virginia is in play right now. Former CIA Director Robert Gates picks to replace Rumsfeld as Secretary of Defense. Rumsfeld ends up falling on his fucking sword today. This is all your fault, Rumsfeld. If this war would have went the way you said, we'd have an all-Republican Congress.
I wonder if it would have made any difference if this announcement was last Tuesday, like a week before the election. Rumsfeld's out, and it just made people think, all right, the Republicans are trying to make some changes here.
You think that would have been the smart move, huh?
Yeah, I think it would have shown that, hey, we're offering something here. Here's our sacrifice, this old crazy man who's running the war.
Yeah, I don't think so, though. I think for whatever reason, this is just one of those times that the country is going, I'm going to fucking pull the leash back in. You're all over the place. You're talking crazy. Look at him today. He's talking like a human being. Have you noticed that? Bush is out. He's talking with people. He's talking normal. He's not being so cocksure. He looks like a guy with a hat in his hand.
Yeah, there hasn't been that many crazy jokes going on. Britney Spears is filing for a divorce.
That's a shocker. I really thought that those two were going to make it. I had good feelings about them.
2 years after marrying K-Fed, 2 months after having this latest baby. So that's all done. K-Fed, this has got to be the last we see of him. I know he's got a wrestling pay-per-view coming up in January, but he's got to be all done.
So he does not have the deal that I initially thought he was going to get a big part of that cash, but they're acting like no now, right?
No, I guess not. I guess with the prenup in place, he's not getting that much. I don't think he's going to get spousal support. She wants the kids, and he's been told to pay for his own lawyer in this thing, too. So she's not even
paying. Why would you pay for the lawyer who's trying to take your money? I can't imagine how stupid that deal would be.
So that's finally over with.
Now, somebody said, I didn't see it, that she did Letterman on Monday night and looked great.
Yeah, she came out of nowhere, came out from behind Letterman's desk,
uh-huh,
and had lost all her pregnancy fat and did look really, really good. She had on this real tiny black outfit.
She had the I'm ready to meet new guys body.
Exactly.
Ready to rock.
So, just giving the eye to Paul Schaefer and David Letterman. And K-Fed, of course, was on wrestling one more time. In the NFL elections, Lynn Swann, he lost his bid to become Pennsylvania governor.
Good. I'll never vote for a Steeler. That will never happen. Oh, wait, thank you very much. He brings in this picture of Brittany. She looks like Brittany again.
Yeah, she's totally back to her old self.
I think she's even hotter than Brittany.
Well, she is still Brittany.
I don't think so.
You think that this is a new person?
Just a wholly new, different human being, because she's very hot.
Yeah, the only problem is that her pussy's been all K-fetted. That's the only problem there.
Also, Heath Shuler, who used to quarterback for the Redskins, he won his election. He's a new member of Congress from North Carolina.
This is the first win I remember Heath Shuler ever being involved with.
So he got a big win. He's a Democrat, and he won.
Now, Shapey, did you spend the night celebrating as a little Democrat?
I was invited to a big party, but I didn't go to it because it didn't work out. It was a big...
Were you excited all night, though?
Yeah, I was...
Because you're all young and hopeful and you believe?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's got to be great.
The world hasn't broken me yet.
Yeah, well, it will. It will, son. That's the beauty of it.
Colorado and Nevada, they both voted against legalizing marijuana. They had had that law... They had passed that vote in Denver a while back about having less than an ounce of marijuana is not a crime.
Yeah.
I think that was the measurement on it. And then Colorado, the whole state was voting on the whole thing. Colorado rejected all that.
How big?
I think it was fairly big.
Because Colorado's a weird state. They're really liberal about some things, really conservative about other things. And they got all those crazy Jesus people that are completely off the fucking hook now.
Oh, yeah, with the New Life Church and Reverend Ted Haggard. One of the guys, James Dobson, he founded the Christian group Focus on the Family. Big deal in the evangelical groups.
FOF?
Exactly. He has quit as a member of the counseling team for Reverend Ted Haggard. He was part of the group, I guess, that was going to straighten him out. And he's saying, I really don't have the time to deal with this.
Let me tell you, you take a guy and try to get him the taste for cock out of his mouth, it's like trying to get a wolf and try to convince him not to eat chicken again. It must be fucking fabulous, because anyone who goes to it once never stops. Has anyone ever quit being gay? I guess Bowie.
And Heche?
Yeah. That's different than cock, Fezzy. All girls are a little lesbian. So. That's when you guys get the confusion between two chicks getting together and two guys getting together. When two chicks get together, 90% of the time, it's not serious. It's just fooling around. When two guys get together, it's fucking serious can be.
Reverend Ted must be gayer than we thought if James Dobson feels he can't even help with this. Lance Bass's boyfriend says that Doogie Howser, Neil Patrick Harris, he wasn't out.
Wait a minute. That Lance Bass goes out with Doogie Howser?
No.
Oh, God, I got fucking totally confused.
No, he goes out with a gay guy that won Amazing Race and is a male model.
Okay, I don't know. I don't follow this.
So this guy, Lance Bass's boyfriend, he says that Doogie Howser, Neil Patrick Harris, wasn't outed. He was lanced. And he says that's the new Hollywood term for a celebrity that's outed by the media. I think he's just trying to get his boyfriend's name to catch on as a catchphrase. Sounds like he's just trying to stay in the news to me.
I don't know. I had no idea that whole scene went down. I don't even know which one Lance is.
Coming out in People is the new African Baby. Coming out in People magazine is the new trend.
That's the new African Baby.
African Babies are so last week.
You are so much the young Fez, I cannot fucking believe it. Mike, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, I got a name for you. Earl probably knows it. Donnie McClarkin.
Donnie McClarkin. Give me an update on him. I'm not familiar with him.
He's a gospel singer. His big old backstory. They even made a movie about him, about how he went from being homo to straight.
Oh, he was able to beat it?
Yeah, after he was found the Lord.
The DL is what I don't trust at all there.
An elementary school in California, they're going to start fingerprinting the students for their lunch program. That way, when the kids are in line to get lunch, they just scan their fingerprint.
You know, I know of a private school that's doing this on Staten Island. Rob, how do you feel about this? This way, that when your kids come into the school, they got to run their fingerprint over so they know everybody knows who they are. So instead of like having an identification card or whatever, it really is kind of a Big Brother thing now, where wherever you go, because I guess eventually that'll be the way you open doors, you start the car. But do you feel like the government and even scarier big corporations know what we're doing at all times?
Yeah, I get scared of that, especially the fact that I know the fingerprint, it's unique and that's why they use it. But we fingerprinted criminals all our lives, so to use a fingerprint for anything, it makes you feel like a criminal.
And you Bible people, isn't this the sign of the beast that you're always so worried about? It really does feel like Now you can be watched. Because, you know, we right away they want to put now cameras on buses in New York City and in the subway cars themselves. And people went, you know, some people are going, well, isn't this a person like, hey, when you go into a 7-Eleven? You know, we've all, the snowball has already started to pick up steam where since you gave up one of these, okay, I don't mind being watched here and there, you're now starting to be watched 60% of the time when you're on the streets. It's going to get up to 90% of the time.
Well, they're never, ever going to just use it for what they say they're going to. Like this lunch program in California.
Right.
They say that's the, you know, to keep track of who's getting government assistance on their lunches and to make the lunch line move faster. You know that people will be getting looked
at. Well, and also, most parents now, you pay the school. It's almost like a fucking debit card thing. So instead of sending your kid into school with $2 every day, the old man will send a check. You know, once a month or whatever, and this kind of gets deducted out of there. But the real point is, it's no longer a card. It's not like a little credit card. It's we're watching you. We know what you're up to. And people are okay because I guess there's some safety into it. But this isn't going to be the same government you're going to have forever. And these aren't going to be the same corporations forever. You know, sometimes you're going to run into either governments or corporations that you're not completely comfortable with. Why do you want to turn over all your strength now is beyond me. But we're doing it, and we don't seem to care much. Derek, you're on the fence.
Hey, what's up, Ron?
Hey, buddy.
I think it's a good idea, but back when I was in high school, I remember I used to save all the lunch money my mom gave me, and I'd go get a bag of pot at the end of the week.
No, I don't even think they've taken that gimmick away from kids where that they don't know where the money ends up in it. Because little kids have fucking cards now.
Oh, yeah.
A kid will have like a fucking debit card that he's going around with instead of having cash on him. Here's Steve. Steve, you're on Run the Fez.
Boys.
Yeah, what can we do for you, buddy?
Hey, listen, I just wanted to say, I got a bunch of kids, and we're always getting these things from the schools that say you should fingerprint and photograph your children now. And, you know, part of you thinks, well, you know, it's a really good idea. But then the criminal side of you thinks, well, maybe they're just fingerprinting them just because they don't live in the right area. And maybe they can come back later on and go, hey, we got your prints.
Right. Now they've got your kids' prints. Let's just figure it that way. So if there's a break-in everywhere, you know what I mean? If there's a break-in at any place in the school or in that community, everybody's fingerprints are now on file. You know, like, that used to only be for fucking perps. That was for bad people. Now all of us are on fucking file at the same time. And again, it doesn't normally seem to scare most people because they're like, hey, I don't do anything wrong. But you're living under a government that you don't completely fear. Now, today, who knows what it's going to be like 20 years from now.
You ever go to a bank that fingerprints you? They
yeah.
have, like Wachovia, they do that?
Right.
And in the summer when I was working for the state, they have their money in Wachovia, and I wanted to cash my first check. And they're like, oh, we need your thumbprint. I'm like, why? And they're like, that's just our policy. I was like, well, do I get it back when you're done? Because I don't know where it is. Now my thumbprint is somewhere in the Wachovia right, corporate yeah. office. And I'm like, what are they going to do?
It's on file forever.
I wrote them a letter. Yeah. I wrote them a letter. I'm like, can I please have my thumbprint back? I just wanted to cash one thing.
But and I know that you're not doing anything wrong. I know none of us are. But I remember being a little kid, and you're taught in school, this in Russia, the government watches you all the time. In Russia, the police are always watching. You have freedoms here. It seems like we just gave up our fucking freedoms without caring anymore.
Yeah, but it's fear these days. I know I have two small kids, and I'm paranoid. I mean, we've had 6 or 7 incidents close to our house where, you know, these perverts are pulling up going, I lost my puppy.
Right. You know, so. But has there really been 6 or 7 close to your house?
Yes, there has. Yes, there has. I mean, it's like on the news. Now, it might be the same person.
Right.
But I know myself, like, I was to the point, I was such a paranoid parent that one night I said to my wife, I said, I'm going on the internet, and I'm not quitting until I find out how many kids are abducted each year.
Right.
They make it seem like it's one every day.
It's true.
And, you know, the actual number of kids that are abducted by a non-family member in
yeah.
this country a year, what would your guess be?
I have no idea. I'm going to tell you the truth.
Between 9 and 11.
In the whole country.
In the whole country.
And yet, because of that 9/11, kids don't go out and play like we played when we were younger.
Exactly.
Halloween is barren.
And they will sell the missing kid because the fucking father decides he wants the kid and doesn't care what the old lady said, which we all grew up with,
right.
Which no one ever thought is of kidnapping. We thought it was a problem between the crazy parents. But now, too, the other thing is, if a kid is kidnapped in Seattle, people in Georgia and Florida are petrified and making their kids stay in. It, you're looking at the same numbers, probably, of kids that get hit by fucking lightning every year.
Exactly.
You got to be careful how much safety that you want. But Rapper is right, particularly when you have little kids, you're fucking petrified now because of the news.
It's exactly the news. And, I mean, they blow everything out of proportion. You know, if CNN has a slow day, they run it all day.
Oh, absolutely.
Well, there always seems to be an Amber Alert.
Well, there's only one story at any given time. Today's story is it's a Democratic Congress. That's going to run for 2-3 days. 2-3 days before that, totally different story. And every news story will only run the one story. You think we have all these news things, you can get news anytime you want. You can basically get the same story over and over and over. Danny, you're on Run and Fez.
Yeah, guys, the fingerprinting of the kid, it's voluntary first, and you as the parent keep the fingerprints and the photos, and then if something happens to your child, that's...
No, that's a whole different thing that we're talking about. That's different than the school district having the fingerprints and you needing that for lunch.
Right.
That's a whole different thing. And one of the things I think about the have the fingerprints in the pictures, it's almost to get us all used to having the fingerprints done. Used to, and everybody is really comfortable with it. Because remember, the changes normally take place over a decade, 2 decades. At one time, would you have believed that you wouldn't be able to smoke into a fucking club? You know what I mean? That you would go into a nightclub where you're drinking and couldn't light up? No one would have fucking believed that. But they keep doing each law a little at a time, the way they roll the DUI back, the way they go, okay, we have smoking sections. We have, as soon as you fucking cop to the smoking section, you were bound to give up smoking for one reason or another. Was going to happen that way.
And you mentioned the DUI and that thing like they did in Fairfax County, Virginia, where the cops were allowed to go in the bar and see who's drunk there. It didn't even matter who was behind the wheel.
Right. If you're going to start and give your safety over to them, guess what? You never fucking have a drink. Why can fucking sitting down and doing shots ever be considered good? It isn't, but it's your fucking choice whether you want to do it or not. Fred, you're on Run and Fez.
Hey, what's up, boys?
Yeah.
And Ronnie, you're absolutely right. With the, especially with the days of the clicker now, or remote control, you go around the stations and it's one news story on the other channel that was just on the past one. And more importantly, then they all go to commercial simultaneously. So
it does. It seems like everybody is on the same goddamn grid together. And that'll get your paranoia going. It definitely will. You'll start and believe it after a while.
We totally watched it this week. John Kerry disappeared off the news as soon as Ted Hagger got caught.
Steve, you're on Run and Fez. Steve, how are you? All right, let me go to Garbage Man. Garbage Man, you're on the Run and Fez show.
Razzle dazzle, buddy.
Razzle dazzle, pal.
the fingerprints with the kids. I see that financially hurting the school bullies or the rappers of the world.
Let me tell you right now. There is some kid right now with a razor getting ready to slice fingerprints off the little pussy kids so that he can get extra milk for the rest of the school year.
Was he referring to me when he said bullies?
You were a little bit of a bully, Rap.
You know, Ronnie, I had a lunch ticket scam going in Catholic school,
yeah.
But there was no bullying involved. A certain person who is now a DA in a county in Delaware, I won't mention, was stealing them. And what I was doing was rather than getting free lunch, I started selling them to the other kids. I wasn't bullying anybody. They were getting a reduced lunch and had a little money left over, and I got to go up June's and play pinball on the weekend.
Give me the first name.
Jay.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
He's a DA now.
Well, he's assistant DA, Ronnie.
Yeah.
But... Yeah, I don't think he would be too happy to have anybody know about that.
Well, his mommy used to make him come in when the fucking streetlights came on anyway. If you're tired, go to bed. If you're tired, go to bed, motherfucker.
And that was a good line.
That was a good line.
A great line. He had to do it underneath of his shirt. The rest of us yelled it out after he did because we weren't afraid.
Fuck. All right, 866-RUN-0-FEZ, 866-RUN-0-FEZ. Rapper, my buddy's there. Now, when Rapp says he went to a Catholic school, Fezzy, he went to the Italian Catholic school.
That's right.
We had the Italian Catholic school, the Polish Catholic school, and the Irish Catholic school. Being Catholic was not enough. It was such a fucking majority in that area. You had to start and break down the ethnic things. By the time we got to you, Earl, there was already 8 or 9 fucking ethnic groups above you.
Still holding up the totem pole, huh?
No, Earl, you would have went to Locust Hill. Don't worry about it. You would have been there with Stevie Mack. How's your day going? Everything get straightened out?
Not at all, but I'm all right.
Yeah. Where'd you stash? Did you have to stash somewhere?
No, not at all.
Back on the streets?
I have no idea.
Never found?
Nope.
Wow. Spooky. Here's Mike. Mike, you're on the Fez.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah.
It's Mike.
Yeah, go ahead, Mike. What can we do for you?
I was actually going to comment. That one guy called and said that he did some research quickly on the internet and found that only actually 9 or 10 kids across the nation are abducted per year or something like that.
Yeah, that's Rapp said that.
It's pretty amazing. Because I thought it was much bigger when I did. I used to be a software architect for a major company, and I quit.
No fucking radio
a couple
show,
months
so
off, and
like
I worked at home in my room, and I wrote software that actually changes. It's actually setting for a patent. It's capable of changing every ad in the internet to an Amber Alert at the same time. And I called the National Foundation for Missing Children. They weren't even interested in it. Pretty unbelievable. I mean, it's all about the news scaring people. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, well, I mean, here's the thing. Most of the time when a kid is missing, it's because the dad decides he wants the kid back. Now, is that scary for that family? Yeah. Should there be some kind of alert to get that kid back for the mother? I guess there should be. But don't make fucking kids now stay inside. Now they can't go into the woods.
People are paranoid enough. This guy wants to throw lighter fluid on the fire.
Right.
Every friggin' ad on the internet goes to an Amber Alert. You'll think a kid's getting snatched every 10 fucking minutes.
Amber Alert!
Jesus Christ!
I mean,
I'll take the fucking advertising over that.
It really does. It really does start to fucking feel like that Tom Cruise future movie where the advertising is paying attention to you.
I don't think he got what I said. I kind of did this to, like, get over my fucking fears, you know.
Right.
Here, this guy, he wants to add to him.
Exactly. And he's like, you fucking believe it? I couldn't sell this. I thought he was going to be a millionaire. But, you know, the weird thing here is, at the same time, when people are going, I don't care if people know where I go online or what I do, the fucking corporations watch you so they can develop advertising directly at you. If that doesn't bother you at all or make you feel a little weird, I mean, if you had a fucking neighbor who was writing down what time you come and go, what day you buy groceries, you would eventually go over there and smack him the side of his fucking head. A large corporation you don't really seem to give a shit about. Will, you're on Fez.
I just want to say, 2004 Amber Alert.
Turn your radio down, bro.
Okay. 2004 Amber Alert, say, 270 reports missing children, and about 70 were people abducted, children under the 17 or under abducted that weren't hoaxes, so weren't false. So 70 in 2004.
That weren't false.
But were they abducted by a non-custodial parent? That's
right.
What I'm saying.
And also, let's also go into this. Does this fucking count as an Amber Alert? A 16-year-old girl leaves with her 22-year-old fucking boyfriend or her fucking 40-year-old next-door neighbor. That's a lot different for you when you're a father of a 7-year-old girl who you're like, you know, you don't consider that the same situation. How many times are these Amber Alerts being blown up because some little girl's basically running away from home?
Maybe if they use something less frightening than the term Amber Alert, like kid news or something. We have some pit news.
Why do we need that even? Why isn't it just there?
To make it a happy thing.
What, you know, Amber Alert was a nice name at once.
Oh, yeah.
Now it's got people. It ain't the fucking word itself. It's the fact that everybody's supposed to drop whatever they're doing and fucking start running like antelope at the first smell of fucking fear in the world. Frank, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, guys, how you doing?
Yeah, don't worry about it, Frank.
I'll try not to. No, I just wanted to say, you know, another way your rights are being taken away is when these cops are pulling you over for not wearing a seatbelt. Who the fuck are they? You know, what do they care if I don't wear a seatbelt or not? Last week, I got hit with a $125 ticket.
Yeah, it really is, and a big part of that, the insurance companies are behind the fucking seatbelt law. But why are our politicians doing the work of the fucking insurance companies? Shouldn't that be between us and the insurance companies? And is it safer if you wear a seatbelt? Yes. But if a guy goes down the fucking road and he's only being of harm to himself, why do the rest of us care?
The politicians get involved in that. They have to have a seatbelt law in their state, because if you don't, then you don't get the Fed money coming in.
But again, Fezzy, you're fucking talking about symptoms. Why is that? Why is it the federal fucking government are involved? That's the fucking question. Why does the insurance companies talk to the federal people who are now making up laws for us?
Yeah, it makes
sense. That's our fucking money that we're paying these people to do, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Who gives a shit whether some other guy's wearing a seatbelt? If you want to wear a seatbelt, put one on. You know what? You're even fucking safer in your car if you wear a crash helmet. You want the whole fucking family to put crash helmets on while you're driving down the road in your SUV? Why don't we fucking line the inside of the car with cotton? So no matter what happens, let's fill the car up with water. So you're fucking driving down and warm water is like a womb. How fucking safe do you want to be? Why are you giving everything away every fucking second of the day? This is the fucking land of the free, home of the brave. Not land of the fucking taken care of, home of the fucking pussies who have to be as safe as possible. I don't understand why we give it up. Here's Steve. Steve, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, listen, the guy got a $125 ticket for not wearing a seatbelt. Why are there no seatbelts on school buses?
There are now. The new buses.
Not on my daughters.
Yeah.
Most of them are not.
I was shocked.
I have new buses in my town.
Oh, boy, what is your fucking town? Safe town? Where are you living? Whoville?
I have more bald eagles than black people in my town, so that's pretty cool.
Man, that's a, why hurt Earl's feelings?
I'm sorry, Earl.
To me, that we're really running out of both.
You still got the high yellows?
I don't see the difference, Earl. No difference at all between high yellow and pitch black. That's me, though. That's one man's opinion. Good point, though. We don't have the seatbelts in there because it's a hassle. That's why it is.
And if the law was so important to be enforced, it wouldn't be a thing where you got ticketed if you got pulled over for speeding and they noticed you didn't have your seatbelt on.
Pat, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, Ron, just wanted to say, a lot of times the people that don't wear their seatbelts and get in accidents, they don't have health insurance or car insurance. So they spend 2 weeks in the hospital. And the taxpayers end up paying for it. So why not fine everybody? Because this is the only way
we're
going
to... Why can't those people not be able to ride in a car then? If it's so fucking important, why are we letting them in cars?
I agree.
So unless you have insurance, you can't get into a car now. That's the way where you want to go with it.
Works for me.
Dang. Where you calling from, Pat? Oh, he hung up.
I'm just curious with the seatbelts. I wonder what the percentage is of people who died trying to get out of the seatbelt after the car crashed as opposed to wear the seatbelt.
Now you're talking like my dad. he used to cut the seatbelts out with a butcher knife before the fucking law came by because he wanted us all to be thrown free of the fucking... I remember being a little kid fucking sleeping up on top of the back's fucking seat. Where you were just laying up there, if my dad would have hit something, I would have shot through there like a torpedo.
My brother was bought this car from a European, a new car, and I guess in Europe they don't like seatbelts because it's restricting to them.
Well, first of all, their cars are so tiny, They can't move as it is.
Right, but it's all about their freedom. So when my brother got the car, he goes, and if you don't want this automatic seatbelt, you can just buy the buckle from a used car lot. So he was actually telling him to buy just the buckle part, put it into the car, and it won't activate the automatic seatbelt. My brother was like, whoa, that's the fucking weirdest thing I've ever heard.
Why don't we just wear seatbelt shirts so you'll get in? It looks like you're wearing a seatbelt, but it's just like having a sash across the front of you. Rick, you're on Running Fizz.
Hi, Ron. Hi, Fizz. How are you doing?
Good.
Good. I want to see how crazy it is up in Canada. I rolled a big truck doing 40 miles an hour. I got fined $150 for not wearing the seatbelt, for taking it off while the truck rolled over. Another point I want to bring across is in the bars, in Lloydminster, four drivers on a Friday night drinking inside the bar. 9 officers come into the bar to check to see who was drunk in the bar. I got thrown inside a slammer for being drunk and disorderly in a public place because we were laughing.
Yeah, that happened in Fairfax when we were living in Northern Virginia. The cops come into the bar. They start doing a fucking DUI test, even though nobody was driving at the time. And if you were intoxicated in a bar, you got busted. Because their point is, the point of a bar is to have a drink, not to get intoxicated. Insane.
That's like, I have a friend who got home drunk.
Let me guess. Online friend? Because you don't have any real life friends.
I have tons of real friends.
All right.
He came home.
There's a poot or toot.
No. No.
Go ahead.
He came home, and he was too drunk, and he forgot his keys, and so he went to his car and went to sleep in his car, and then a cop knocked on the window, and he got a DUI for just sleeping in his car.
Right. Rapp will back me up on this. The cops in our town, they would fucking pull you over. They'd put the flashlight in. You guys smoking dope? No, all we have is this beer. All we have is this beer. You swear to God. All right, I'm going to let you go. But I don't want you guys doing dope. They fucking, to them at that point, and then it was just like a couple years later, around 83, 84.
83, yeah.
They fucking decided, no. It's all about DUIs.
Well, that's when the DUI law came into effect. But, you know, it's like even in our neighborhood, my first drink I had legally in Pennsylvania, I was there on vacation, and I had moved out when I was like in the 20.
Right.
And we went to bars like it was nothing.
Yeah, we could get in bars at like 14 years old. You would be fucking sitting at a bar with your fucking chain in front of you. And I'm not fucking making it up
because
they just would feel like, all right, they're here in the bar, they're safe. If they start to get rowdy, at least they're in this situation. It was like a little European thing. And I mean, the minute that you would start and swing a fucking pool cue, they would be down on top of you to teach you the ways of the world.
That happened to me one time in Max Millions. I beat the shit out of one of the Koch brothers. I was 19 years old. I laughed. I figured, fuck, I'm underage, you know. I got in a fight. He comes out and gets me. He goes, you didn't start it. I went back in, finished drinking.
Oh, Max?
Yeah.
Which brother did you beat up, the straight one or the gay one?
I wasn't a gay person.
Why you got this on your record? Why you're fucking patting your record? I'm asking, did you beat up the one who already came out, who was Lance, very recently or not?
It was the straight one.
Because I'll pat my record if I need to. I'll go up over 100 wins. Most of our wins, it was 4-5-1 anyway. So it's really like a shared sack. It's like,
Ronnie, we were the little guys. Yeah. Me and you just pretty much hit him.
Here's Gord. Gord, you're on the fence.
Hey, how you doing today?
Yeah.
I'm with a Jaws rescue team, and when you're in the city, you know, wearing a seatbelt is, pretty simple thing. You're going to save yourself some injuries, but when you're on the freeway, and I'm not saying not to wear a seatbelt, when we come to a scene where a person's been in a head-on collision or T-boned or rolled or whatever, a lot of times we're cutting the seatbelts off of a body because the seatbelts cause internal injuries, and if you're not dead, we can't treat you. You know, we've got to get you into an ambulance, get you to an OR. And, you know, it's a double-edged sword.
Right.
You know, you wear it and you take...
Yeah, you haven't put on a suit of armor. It's just a fucking belt to keep you from flying around. Yeah, most people that die are wearing seatbelts, too. You know, it just doesn't mean that you're suddenly safe because you got a seatbelt on. Plus, how are you supposed to find shit that you're stuck under your seat? You got to undo that belt for that. I got CDs under there. Here's Robin. Robin, you're in Ron and Fez.
Hey, guys. Real quick, when you were talking about sleeping in the back window, I also remember riding with my grandparents, sitting on the console in the front seat because I wanted to be tall and up with them and be able to see out. But going back to the lunch thing, they in Dallas, they track what the kids eat. So the other day, this girl I work with called in, found out her kid was buying cookies and candy and stuff, and said she picked her up from work, and the kid was all pissed off at her because she blocked her from being able to buy any sort of sweets or anything like that.
Oh, so the mother was able to keep her on the diet because now you're on the no-fat girl fucking plan.
Now this is going entirely too far. I am disgusted by this, and this needs to be put to an end immediately.
Well, you know, if you got an easy pass, everybody knows where exactly you are. You can be fucking traced right back to that neighborhood at any time, because they'll know when you use easy pass, what time of the day it took place. Same if you're using an ATM. Everybody knows exactly where it is. Plus, your picture's being taken while you're on the ATM. They can fucking see if you're all gacked up 3 o'clock in the morning, rolling through there.
That's going to be the Duke rape case alibi. They got that one kid at the ATM when the rape was supposedly going on.
It's our buddy Jafter. Does anybody remember Jafter?
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Good.
God, that easy pass, that's another thing. I think they were thinking about trying to give people tickets if you went from one toll to the next in a shorter period of time.
Too quick, yeah. Like, yeah. If you're on the Jersey Turnpike, they would be able to tell, wait a minute, he fucking got on here, the next Easy Pass is here, he had to be doing 70, 75.
Exactly. Now, Ronnie, when you were a kid, how did you get a Coke when you were in school?
We didn't have Cokes in our school.
Oh, you did?
No.
Oh, no, for us, we had to sneak into the teacher's lounge.
Yeah, maybe the lounge had one, but they would only sell juices and milk at our school.
Yeah, juice and milk, but not soda.
Right.
These kids now, they have all these vending machines. And plus, when you were a kid, you got pulled over the cops, you know, like in D.C., it was like, oh, you got beer? They just take it from you. That was your punishment.
I got to admit, nothing that I had, no lunch money ever went to fucking lunch for me, personally. It went down to that beer distributorship in Hook. What was the name of that place?
Marcus Hook Beverage.
Marcus Hook Beverage.
He'd serve any of us.
Gary I don't know what was supposed to go first or second name, but he was only a year older anyway. So he was always working with that little fucking hat on, like he was in the East Street Band. What do you guys need? Rubbing his fucking belly. But, I would never have wasted my lunch money on lunch.
I was the opposite. I went in the hole. I was doing double lunches. I was so hungry, I never got enough food at that place.
Well, hungry's a choice, Fezzy. You don't have to be. There's a little fucking powder to make you forget all about your fucking hunger pangs.